Hi everyone. In this video, we're going to be talking about the general properties and characteristics of thermoplastic polymers. In a previous video, we briefly went through the key differences between a thermoplastic polymer and a thermoset polymer. However, now that we know a bit more about polymers, we can get a bit more in depth about thermoplastic polymers. So, let's remember broadly what a thermoplastic polymer is. A thermoplastic polymer's most defining characteristic is that it can be heated and reshaped any way that we want. So, if we had this square solid thermoplastic material here, all we would need to do is bring its temperature up to its melting temperature, at which point there is enough energy present to break all the minor bonds holding the polymers in place. These are typically hydrogen bonds and van der Waals forces. This allows the polymers to slide around each other and reorient themselves, which is why we can physically reshape them. Once we have the thermoplastic in the shape that we want, we remove the energy source, that is the heat, and let them cool down. Once the energy of the system is too low to break the minor bonds, then the polymers become a solid again, in the new shape, like this weird S shape for example. So, from this, we can infer that thermoplastics do not have any cross-linking that is significant, as this would prevent the polymers from sliding around one another, as they would be locked into a 3D lattice. For more details about this cross-linking, check out our thermoset properties video in the description below. So, let's talk about the properties and stability of thermoplastics as a generality. Just note that no matter which category a polymer may fall under, thermoplastic versus a thermoset, the properties within a single category can be widely different, even though they appear to be very similar polymers. And this is what makes polymers really amazing. There are so many potential use cases and so much that we can do with polymers that makes them such an interesting field to study. Thermoplastics are generally easy to color compared to thermosets, such as colored LDPE bags you may get from the grocery store. Thermoplastics are also great for creating items that are transparent. Thermoset polymers are very limited in terms of the polymers that are actually see-through, whereas there are many thermoplastics that can be used for this. In terms of toughness, thermoplastics are generally much better than thermosets. This means that they can absorb more energy and deform more plastically without breaking. This causes thermoplastics to have a lower tensile strength but a higher elongation to break than thermoset polymers. In terms of cost, thermoplastics are generally much cheaper than thermosets to produce. This is caused by numerous reasons, such as they are easier to process, recycle, and they're often less specified than many thermosets, which often are created for one specific application only. Although many thermoplastics have great chemical resistance, thermosets are significantly better at this. In general, thermoplastics are synthesized using addition polymerization, which we will talk about in depth in a future video. Building on this, industrially, thermoplastics are often produced via blow molding, casting, thermofolding, rotational molding, injection molding, and several other methods. Eventually, I hope to cover all of these production methods more in depth, so look out for those videos in the future. Thermoplastics also generally have a lower molecular weight than thermosets, which should make sense, right? If we had a massive macromolecule for our thermoplastic polymer, we would have a hard time moving that around versus a small snake-like polymer, like linear low-density polyethylene. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your general understanding of some of the thermoplastic polymer properties and some of the ways that we can produce them. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.